Now curbing conflicts in high school. Hari Sreenivasan looks at a new approach to discipline that replaces suspensions with conversations.
In Aurora, Colorado, Principal Matthew Willis welcomes the recent changes at Hinkley High School, where 75% of the 2,000-plus students qualify for free and reduced meals. Willis says student fights are down and respect among classmates is up.
Last year, we had a 48% reduction in out-of-school suspensions. When it came to physical altercations between students, in 2007-08, we had approximately 263 physical altercations. And so far for this year, we've only had 31 physical altercations.
So good morning. Thank you for being here.
The turnaround, he says, began when Hinkley High started using a form of discipline called restorative justice.
Every single year over the last three full years that we've been doing restorative justice, you see significant declines in defiance, disobedience, and use of profanity.
This is called a talking circle, so when we have problems in the school, we come together and talk about it.
Now, when a minor altercation does occur, students, parents, and the dean face each other in a restorative circle.
Restorative is that you bring back the kids, if it's student with student, or if it's student with staff, you restore the relationship. So if there's conflict or wrongdoing, we come together and we talk about it and we try to heal the harm that was caused from the incident.
So thank you for everything you said so far, and now this is...
Dean of Students Bonnie Martinez facilitates.
We speak openly and honestly, but with respect.
On the day we visited, two sophomore girls caught up in a physical fight were brought to a circle with their parents instead of being suspended.
So this is our talking stick. So who's ever holding this is the ones talking and everyone else is listening. You say what happened from your point of view and you say what happened from your point of view. And sometimes we don't always agree on all the facts or whatever.
She called me the B word and then we just started fighting.
That's kind of a layer of you. She say to be honest, and I think you have to be honest. I was here and she come walking to me and said, she's talking.
Students are asked to talk about the harm their actions may have caused, and Martinez requires everyone to sign an agreement.
What do you take responsibility for? What do you think we could do to heal the harm that was caused?
I'm sorry for having these problems that we've been having, and I don't want it to happen again.
Okay. You're not going to be enemies, but you're going to treat others with respect. That, to some people, may be viewed as a soft discipline, especially if you look at the Western culture. You know, we're about war and violence. We're not about peace and harmony. But however, for those girls to come together and for their families to come together and talk about it and to really, you know, to express truly what happened, how did it affect me and others, what am I responsible for and how do I solve it, that's deeper than just writing up paperwork and one person goes their way and the other person goes their way and nothing was ever communicated.
What do we know about anger?
It's a secondary feeling.
It's a secondary feeling. What is underneath anger?
A deeper emotion.
Like a lot of deeper emotions and feelings.
At Hinkley, the restorative justice circles go beyond the dean's office. Peer mentoring classes use role-playing to teach students how to conduct circles on their own.
How does it make you feel?
It pisses me off that he's spreading rumors about me, I didn't do nothing big.
Sophomore Nye Smith thinks the circles bring better results than suspension.
It used to be like you just get sent home for 5 days, but that doesn't resolve nothing. You just sit there and you come back with the same anger.
When teachers don't resolve the harm by doing restorative justice, then that conflict is always there. And usually what will happen is kids will just stay angry. And I don't like that teacher, and so I don't care what you say, and they'll just disrupt.
I'm deeply sorry about what's going on. And if you
models like Hinkley's have gained national attention after the Obama administration in January directed school districts to scrap overly zealous zero-tolerance policies that led to automatic suspensions and criminal records. Such policies, the official said, impacted minorities at higher rates. Colorado's legislature eliminated zero tolerance in schools in 2012.
The ideas of traditional discipline don't exist anymore. When in the old days, when a student or a kid got into trouble, we would spank them. And we moved away from spanking because it no longer met the values of our society. The same is true with a traditional discipline where It's all about punishment, punishment, punishment. It's not about restoring relationships. It's not about taking responsibility for your actions. It's about punishment. And so that no longer fits the society of our future. What fits the society of our future is people coming together and working and solving problems together.
Gracias. Mucho gusto. Gracias.
And while Colorado is now ahead of the national movement, the state actually played a role in the making of zero tolerance policies after the 1999 shootings at Columbine High School.
Anytime you're in a school, you've got all these stakeholders.
Sarah Park is the director of education for the Denver Foundation, one of the sponsors of Hinkley's restorative justice program.
In Colorado, our zero tolerance law was really in response to Columbine. And we were scared. We were all heartbroken. We were terrified, and we wanted to make sure kids were safe. And so we thought, well, let's do this. Let's make sure, let's make clear that this is non-negotiable. And that's really where the intention around zero tolerance came from. Unfortunately, the way it played out was in more negative educational outcomes. You can't learn if you're not there. And they also, there's studies linking suspension to incarcerations, and it's much more likely that a kid is suspended and repeatedly suspended that they'll end up in jail. And it's much more likely that if they're suspended even once in ninth grade, they're more likely to drop out.
Aurora police officer Jake Bunch, who's assigned to Hinkley High School, says social media has accelerated his need to rely on personal connections that can come from restorative justice.
With like Facebook and Twitter, information just spreads so quickly now that, you know, it's hard to stay on top of it because the kids know about something that's going to go down way before we could ever know. If kids, you know, if I build that relationship with them and they know they can come talk to me before it becomes a violent issue, it ties right in with restorative justice.
What is the role of an individual in society?
Not all conflicts can be resolved through restorative circles. Even supporters see the process as one of many approaches. And skeptics question if stopping down class time for circles limits learning. Test scores at Hinkley High School hover below the state average. For his part, Principal Willis remains a strong believer in the approach and is sharing the school's method with districts across the state.